Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mischa Dohler. I'm presenting the tutorial on machine-to-machine for smart grids and smart cities. I'm presenting this tutorial in conjunction with my co-speaker, Dr. Jesús Alonso, who is a colleague with me here at CTTC. This recording has been done for the IEEE Communication Society, and we're going to give you a very brief overview of the tutorial contents which we are going to present to you over the next 3 to 4 hours. I will introduce to you the concept of machine-to-machine, what it is all about. It is really about a system where machines communicate with other machines without any human intervention. That means you would like to deploy a large amount of sensors or actuators, sensing or actuating in the field, reporting the data to a control center without any human being in the loop. Naturally, this cannot happen since a lot of machines will be deployed in the field and human intervention would just be too costly. So we're going to spend a while on the definition of machine-to-machine systems. The tutorial itself will be essentially composed of four parts. The first part will be an introduction. I will introduce you various machine-to-machine systems, a little bit of the history, of the challenges, of the novelties. I will then talk about markets, market developments, about very promising markets like the smart grid market or the smart city market, where machine-to-machine technology will be a very integral part of the whole technology scene. I will then present in a second part the capillary machine-to-machine systems. Capillary machine-to-machine, it's a term which has been coined within ETSI M2M, and it deals essentially with systems where you have short-range communication using Zigbee-like of wireless networks or Bluetooth-like of wireless networks or wireless LAN. So we're going to be talking about the various systems which are currently on the market. Then my co-speaker, Jesús Alonso, will be taken on with the cellular M2M, a very promising market, a very promising technology which is emerging, most likely going to be operational within a few years. He will be actually introducing the challenges which are surrounding the cellular M2M. He's going to be talking about various standardization bodies like ETSI M2M, about 3GPP MTC, and he will be highlighting all the research novelties which have to be done in the context of that type of system. Now, I will be concluding the presentation. Well, just summarize what we have learned during the whole presentation and the tutorial, and I will outline some future research trends. As an example, just some excerpts from some slides from the presentation. Here I show you the timeline of machine-to-machine, where the term itself originated really within the Nokia family when they introduced the Nokia M2M gateway software and the connectivity terminal along with the development kit. That happened around 2002. Having said that, a lot of machine-to-machine systems have existed before that. We have a very healthy wired machine-to-machine community, a community which should not be underestimated. Indeed, about 40% of all machine-to-machine systems today are wired and likely remain to be so. We also have the cellular systems emerging, capillary and hybrid systems, and I'll be dwelling on a few examples for you how these type of M2M systems are being used in the industry today. As an example, the novelty of the wireless M2M system, what we typically use is that slide here where I'm projecting three dimensions. We have on the y-axis the data rate, on the x-axis the distance covered, and on the z-axis, which is not really visible, very well visible here, the power which is being consumed. Now, we understand that low rate, low distance, Zigbee type of systems, which have been well covered by these type of systems, low rate, high data rate is Wi-Fi type, ultra wideband, which has also been well covered. Contrary on the long distance and high data rate, we have the LTE systems, which is very well covered, also from a technological point of view. Whereas the long range and low rate systems, just small machines, sensors, which are placed in the field, sending a message, a bit, saying, hello, I'm alive, or a Coke machine saying, hey, I need more Cokes to be refilled in my machine, these type of systems, which need to communicate over long distance with very low rate, that's the novelty of machine to machine. Popular markets, we'll be dwelling on some of these. Popular markets today is telemetry, naturally. We'll explain why. Smart city market is an emerging market where really ICT technology will play a very central role in making that happen. So we're going to dwell a little bit on the machine-to-machine for smart city applications. We'll also talk about smart grid applications where machine-to-machine really helps to make the grid more efficient. As an example, let me show you the stakeholders of a smart city which was developed in the PPP out smart. So you see, essentially, you have the smart city market, and around you have the stakeholders, which are the cities, the citizens, and the utilities. And a lot of there evolves around the stakeholders, such as the technology, and we'll be talking about this technology, and I'm giving you a small example here. We'll show you the smart city operating system, a concept which is emerging now. Similar to our computer operating system, cities would like to have smart city operating systems where they will be feeding data in, be it from the internet, crowdsourced from the people, or from sensors deployed all over the place, all over the city. Now, these sensors are exactly my machine-to-machine devices. There will be a lot of those. We don't want any human intervention. They're collecting a lot of data. It goes into the smart city operating system. It's being processed to help to improve the efficiency of the city, offer new services, and just power, essentially, new applications. I will then show you how machine-to-machine is being used in smart grids. An example here from Sunelec, you see the grid starting to become more and more distributed. That means the appearance of the microgrid is taking part, and we will be deploying machine-to-machine devices to control and monitor the stability and the operations of this emerging grid paradigm. Also, an example I'll be showing you is the IEEE 2030 interoperability concept. Well, I'll show you exactly how IEEE makes the communication society work with the power community to merge essentially the ICT M2M technologies with the power community to facilitate a more power efficient grid. I will then move on to the capillary networks. And the main thrust of that part of the presentation will be on standardization. Because today we have moved beyond the academic wireless sensor networking deployment. We are interested in industrial and standardized solutions. So a major part of my tutorial will be actually on these standards which are available today. What is out there? Well, we got the IEEE standardizing the physical medium access control layer and the IETF standardizing the networking transport application layers and all what is above. Now, Zigbee-like systems, which are capillary-like systems, they enjoy from the IEEE side the standardization of the IEEE 915.4/2006 standard, which is a good physical layer. There's an emerging 15.4E standard, which I will explain to you how it works and why it is so important to have that medium access control in place to make M2M happen. From the networking point of view, a lot of things have happened in past months in the IETF. We have the 6LoWPAN working group facilitating IPv6 connectivity in these really low-power embedded networks. We have the IETF role group facilitating the routing taking place in these embedded networks, and then we have the IETF core group essentially taking care of the applications and the limitations which are due to the embedded design. Now, my presentation on that part in the past months has only been on the embedded Zigbee-like systems. However, things moved on very quickly, and I've been preaching for 2 years already that one day there will be a low-power Wi-Fi option available to the capillary M2M community, and that has taken shape and reality now. So for the first time, I would like to present you some examples and some results from the low-power Wi-Fi community, and I would like to explain to you why that is a serious competitor to the 15.4 type of capillary networking.
Well, in this tutorial, we will also talk about the role of cellular networks in the M2M whole picture. This is the outline of the part of the tutorial devoted to cellular communications. In this tutorial, we go through the fundamentals of cellular systems and we discuss how cellular systems can have an important role in deploying M2M applications. We will discuss how good or how bad existing technologies and future technologies such as LTE Advanced can be for the deployment of M2M applications. And an important part of the tutorial will be focused on the main standardization activities carried out by ETSI and 3GPP. In the past, the data traffic has been suffering an exponential growth over the last years. And this trend is expected to follow in the future. What we expect is that in the future, the amount of data we want to transmit through the cellular networks is going to increase exponentially. Indeed, what we see is that the evolution of technology, the different generations of cellular networks, have evolved so that they can satisfy the needs of users wanting to transmit more and more bits per second with quality of service requirements. So this is the generation, the evolution of the generations we can see over the last years. However, things are changing because now we talk about machine-to-machine communications where the scenario is completely different because of many reasons. First of all, machines are going to be many more than humans. We are lots of people in the world, but nothing compared to the number of users of machines that we're expecting to have in the near future. There are some characteristics that are different between humans and machines. For example, humans will tolerate delay and jitter. Some machine-to-machine applications, such as control applications, will not accept this kind of delay and jitter. In addition, humans will like to download a lot. This is changing with all this social networking and interactive networking, but still, we prefer to download rather than upload. And this is going to be different in machine-to-machine applications, where most of the machines will want to sense the environment and transmit this information in the uplink. Energy efficiency is a key factor for machine-to-machine applications. It's a key issue. For example, we don't mind recharging our mobile phones in a daily basis. However, machines have to run for years autonomously. Therefore, energy efficiency is a must. And this is a completely mentality shift for the design of cellular networks. In addition, we can raise an alert when something is wrong, when something is not working properly, or our communicating device has been stolen. However, if we have a machine that is autonomously working, we need to design mechanisms to know that something is going wrong. Therefore, we need to rethink how cellular networks run. And all of that, bearing in mind that humans and machines, we have to live together. So in a summary, what we present in this tutorial is which has been the role of cellular communications in the past as a passive data bearer, as a passive pipe for the transmission of data, and how things change, and now network operators have an opportunity to become active players. In the tutorial, we go through the pros and cons of cellular communications, how cellular networks can be useful for machine-to-machine communications. In addition, an important part of the tutorial is focused on the main standardization activities specially carried out by ETSI and 3GPP. In addition, in the tutorial, we also raise and we identify some open research topics. There are many, many open research problems that need to be solved. So there is a lot of room for innovation in different areas. For example, we have to redesign the cellular networks so that they can operate with huge number of devices. There are opportunities to reduce control signaling in many applications. We can think of congestion control algorithms on security techniques because machine-to-machine applications will deal with confidential information in many cases, so security is a very important issue. The design of ultra-low-power operation of the networks is critical because we need to ensure the machine-to-machine applications can run for years. We have to define efficient medium access control protocols. We can enable communication between devices. We can think of cognitive and cooperative approaches and many, many, many other topics of interest that remain open. So this is what we will present in this tutorial, the role of cellular networks in the whole machine-to-machine picture.
At the end of the presentation, I'll be summarizing the challenges for the capillary machine-to-machine systems. We'll be talking about delays, security standards, peer-to-peer traffic abilities. We will also summarize the challenges for the cellular M2M system, which mainly pertain to complexity, power, data rates, delay, and also an architectural design which very much at the M2M has been taken care of in the past months. We will also be summarizing 10 predictions for M2M for the next year, and I hope you will enjoy the longer version of this tutorial, which you can download from the IEEE Communication Society website. Thank you very much.